What's up? Welcome back to my channel. Today's been a rough day, but it'll be alright. So, in today's video, I have two things to talk about. One is my December gift basket giveaway. There's a whole list of stuff that's going to be put in that basket to include 4 tubes of Cushion Grip. So, all you have to do is follow me on Instagram and Facebook and send me a direct message with a heart emoji and you will be entered. And I believe I put on there that December 2nd is when I will pick the winner. So make sure you enter for that. So on to the next thing. What we're going to talk about today is the different ways that you can apply Cushion Grip to get the best possible, that's the word, complete brain fart. Can't think of the word I'm trying to think of. Golly. Anyway, that way you can get optimal use out of Cushion Grip. So, I ordered me a, tooth thing off of Amazon. It was one of them little open and close ones that usually the dentists use, and it's for like showing you how to, you know, kids showing them how to brush their teeth and things like that. But I took it apart, and if you follow me on Instagram or Facebook, you saw what happened when I was working on it. I sliced my finger open, and now I have a little gnarly scar. So yeah, lots of fun. And just so everybody knows, you know, I talked about heart disease and having to get a heart cath done. And my heart cath came back completely normal, no blockages, nothing. Doctor literally said, stay healthy. So that's good. We still don't know why it's accelerating in beats per minute, but I don't know. We'll figure it out. So, anyway, on to the Cushion Grip. So, on this, I have 3 different colors of glitter. There's a purple, there's a green, and there's a blue. Now, I get asked all the time, I just need to snug up. What can I do to get my denture to fit a little bit snugger without having to go through the whole process of a soft reline or paying out of pocket to go back to your denturist and pay them to do a soft reline or whatever? Cushion Grip is perfect for that. So, if you are just needing a snug up on your denture, this is what you need to do. The purple is around this edge right here. And this is for upper denture, okay? So you just need to snug it up. What you wanna do is you wanna start here and put a thin layer, no thicker than, let's say, business card thickness, along this edge right here. Go all the way around it, okay? If you just put it there, you're going to end up with sore spots. Because let's pretend that the rest of the palette is right here, okay? If you, cat's fixing to jump in front of the screen. Really, Polly? Just pretend that the rest of the palette is here. If you don't put any kind of Cushion Grip or anything right here, you're going to end up with sores because it's not going to sit right. So, after you do along the wall of your denture, you want to get probably about an almond size and put it on the palette. Smooth it out really thin. Go down into the wells of your denture. Smooth it out really thin. And then, very important, when you go to put your denture in, make sure that you are pushing up firmly on both sides and in the center. Now, the way I do it is I do both sides, and then when I go to do my top, or the center where the palette is, the top of the palette is, I'm tired. Anyway, when you push up in the center, if it's quiet enough, you will be able to hear all the little air bubbles bursting, which is what you want. I do that until I no longer hear them. I probably spend 7 to 10 minutes just pushing up on my denture, just to make sure that the cushion grip has enough time to, one, not only set up because it is heat activated, and two, so that I make sure that it mirrors every single part of my gums that it can possibly get. And then I leave my denture in for 2 to 3 hours. And then at that point, if there's anything that needs to be trimmed off because it overflowed, then I take it out, trim it off, put it back in. After 2 to 3 hours, you can take your denture out for the night and let it soak in water. It's completely fine. If you do it before a minimum of 2 hours, the likelihood that it's going to shrivel up is more than 50%. If it shrivels up and it looks like a raisin, you have to peel it off and do it all over again. Okay? Now, step number two, if there's too much space between your denture and your gums, let's say because your center palate area is hitting the roof of your mouth before the wells of your denture are, that's where the green comes into play. You want to put, I say about an almond and a pea size in the well of your denture. Don't spread it out. Just put it in there and then push it down. And another question I always get, it sticks to your finger. Cushion grip is super sticky. If you're pushing it down just to get it to stay where you put it and it's sticking to your finger, just in the same spot with firm pressure, just do this. It'll stick right back to itself. You won't have nothing to worry about. And then once you do that in the well of your denture, because there's too much space, then you can get a small snake size strip and go around where the purple is. That way you have some kind of cushion and your gums are not on a hard denture. Now, I cover my whole denture in cushion grip. I do put the bulk of it where the purple is because I just need a snug up. I cannot wear my denture without cushion grip. It gives me sores like you would not believe. And I'm actually going to probably have to go back to DDS because they're going to have to shave off more of my palate area because it's hitting before the rest of it hits, which is causing problems. Cushion grip fixes those problems, but when I'm having to use twice as much cushion grip, then we have a problem. Excuse me. So, if you just need, on the third one, if you just need some kind of cushion all over your denture, cushion grip is great for that. So, again, pretend we have the rest of our denture here for our upper. The blue is where you want to start and put your cushion grip and put it all over the top palate portion. My brain is not working. Over this portion, the bulk of it, and then spread thin layers down into the well and onto the wall. and you literally just spread it all over. If you get too much, don't worry. As long as you are applying firm, constant pressure after you've inserted your denture, there will be no problem. Anything that's extra that there's no room for, it will spill out and you can just trim it off. For lowers, because we're using this one because there was no way I was messing with the other part of that apparatus, ooh, that I got and trying to cut myself again. I pick up anything sharp and everybody's like, be careful, be careful. So, yeah. Basically the same thing will go for your lower denture. Except if you're just needing a snug fit on your lower, you have basically this area from here to here that really grabs on to those front gums. So that's where you want to put the bulk of your cushion grip, is on each wall in that area. And spread a thin layer down onto the flanges, where making sure that you have equal cushion grip on each side and each flange, because otherwise you could end up being lopsided. I don't have a lower denture. This is just what I've learned from talking to other people who do have a lower denture. We have another brand ambassador who has a lower denture, and the way he does it is a thin layer of cushion grip all over his lower denture. I feel like I'm gonna sneeze. And there's a sneeze coming. But he puts a very thin layer across the whole bottom denture, lets it sit for 5 minutes, and then puts another layer on there. Sometimes he said it takes up to three or four layers, but the more you do it that way, down the road, you'll be able to put on exactly how much you need, and you won't have to do it layer by layer. So it'll be a whole lot easier and less time consuming. But that's pretty much the gist of it. These cats, some trying to get in, some trying to get out. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I know it's not a super long video. I will tell you, I got my last application, I got 47 days out of, which is the longest I've ever gotten with one application. And when I went to take my cushion grip off, I didn't have any more of the wooden sticks, which turned out to be totally awesome. I used a cuticle pusher, the plastic one, and I meant to grab it and I didn't. Let me see if I got one in here. I'm sure I do. I got like four of them things. But there is, yeah, there we go. This is not the one I used on my denture, I promise you. Cuticle pusher looks like this. It's got the beveled end, and then it's got basically a thinner pointed end. I used this end. I soaked my denture for 10 minutes, got up a free edge on the back edge of it, and just went to town. I mean, you want to kind of push in and lift up, and then push in and lift up. And that's exactly what I did. And I went around this side to about right here, and then went around this side to about right here, because I bite a lot with my front teeth. So it was like really stuck right here. And you guys, it came out in one piece, which I've never had. Usually you've seen from my other videos, I'm a very impatient person. So I usually end up ripping it into like a bazillion pieces, but I mean, in record time, you guys, it took me like 5 minutes, I promise you, to get that completely off my dinger. I was so happy. So definitely recommend these. More cost efficient than buying all the wooden ones, and work so much better. You know, if you see my previous videos, I've mangled those wooden ones just trying to get the cushion grip out, but this thing works like a dream. So yeah, I think that's gonna be it. My throat is so dry. Don't forget about the gift basket giveaway. Make sure you enter that, you guys. Ow, bad kitty. Some really good stuff in there. If you go to my Instagram or go to my Facebook page, a picture, a post is there that says everything that is going to be in that basket. So yeah, make sure you enter that. Cat. Let's see. Don't forget, you can always go to www.mycushiongrip.com. You can learn all about cushion grip there, even more. Brain fart. You can use my code on a full-size tube. Use code UNSTOPPABLE at checkout. And as always, it's free shipping. Oh, yeah. Cushion Grip has relaunched a YouTube channel. They have some really, really cool content on there, you guys. They posted a video on how cushion grip is made, which was totally awesome. It's this big old glob of orange stuff, and it, like, cushion grip for life, I swear. But yeah, go check them out. I'll leave a link in the description below, and I will leave my link tree my link tree link in the description below. That way you can get to all of my platforms as well as the Cushion Grip website, their Facebook page, and their YouTube channel. So yeah, go check it out, you guys. I love you guys. Remember to be unstoppable in everything that you do. Don't let anybody hold you back. You define your future. Love you guys. Bye.